Hey, what's up, everybody? Dornell Dana here, coming at you with another kick-ass episode of the Art of Mortgage Marketing podcast. This is a special edition, a freedom edition. And of course, we would not have a better day to do a freedom edition than on Freedom Day. It is Veterans Day in the US of A and Remembrance Day in Canada. So what better day to do a freedom edition than on Veterans Day and Remembrance Day? So here we go. We're going to talk about five productivity hacks, not haps, but hacks, five productivity hacks for maximizing your freedom so you can earn more while working less, earning more while working less. So it's really about how not to put in more hours, but more importantly, how to get more from the hours you're already putting in. How can you squeeze as much profit-producing nectar out of your day? We all have the same amount of time per week, 168 hours per week. Whether you are a pauper living on the street or the president in the White House, you have the same amount of time, 168 hours a day. And it's how you use that time or invest that time that determines your prosperity, your future, and your results. So it's all about discerning, how can we maximize your time? How can we leverage your time? How can we have more flow and fun and fulfillment with the time you're putting in so you have less battery draining activities that give you a thumper and have you feel drained, and more of the things that ignite you and excite you that are inside of your circle of competency, your zone of genius, your superpowers that have you feeling great each and every day. So that's what we're going to be talking about today, is what are those hacks? What are those little hinges that swing open big doors to big breakthroughs that you can start to enact in your daily routine that can really push the needle on profit and performance in your business? So let's get into it and do it, shall we? Let's talk about the five hacks for maximizing your freedom. Feel your freedom in advance. What does that mean? It means get connected to the outcome you want to create for your life. Most people don't get what they want because they don't know what they want. They don't know even what freedom looks like or feels like. They don't have the outcome in mind. So the first place to start is, if you had your business the way you wanted it, what would that look like? How would you know that you had it the way you want it? Imagine you're earning the income you want to earn with the lifestyle you want to be enjoying with your family, with the free time that you want, with the opportunity to do what you want with whom you want anytime you want. And how would you know you have it the way you want it? And then, of course, the next step is to really get connected to the feeling of it. It's not enough to just have it in your head. You got to have it in your heart, because driving up the mountain of success requires fuel. The fuel to get there is not a big list of to-dos. It's not a bunch of stuff you should do. It's not a bunch of stuff that you need to do, but rather it's the feeling as if you already are at the top of the mountain. It's the feeling of victory. It's the feeling of freedom. It's the feeling of knowing it's already yours now. So what would that feel like when you're making the kind of money you want to make, with the freedom you want to have, with the flexibility on your terms you want to have that would let you know you're living the dream? What would that feel like? Allow yourself to just get connected to that. Allow yourself to just take some deep breaths and drink that in. Drink in the freedom. Drink in that income that lets you have the freedom you want. Drink in the lifestyle, the free time, the flexibility, the fun, the adventure, and imagine it's already yours now. Puts a smile on your face, doesn't it? Puts a smile on your heart as well, does it not? That's the vibration of victory that you want to start to transmit every single day. You want to get connected to that. You want to get connected to that feeling. And the reason for that is the fuel that drives your engine up the mountain to success. Without getting connected to that feeling, you're going to peter out. You're going to hit obstacles and challenges and turbulence and friction points. And those hurdles are going to stop you if you don't have that feeling of success in your heart every single day. because it's that feeling that has you overcome the obstacles, the challenges, that has you eat challenges for breakfast all day, every day, because you cultivate a sense of certainty that it's already yours. Just like you placed an order on Amazon, you know that box has your name on it and it's en route. You've placed the order, it's en route, it's got your name on it. It's that kind of certainty you want to cultivate. Because if you got 1% doubt, you're out. So you've got to cultivate that certainty that is already yours. That's the first step. And how are you ever going to create freedom if you don't know what freedom looks like and feels like? Just like, how are you going to hit a basket in basketball if you don't actually have a hoop to shoot for? So clarity is power, but also certainty is power. And you don't get certainty just because you hope for it or you wish for it. You get certainty by cultivating it. It's a muscle and you got to build it on a daily basis. So that's the first step, is feel your freedom in advance every single day. Cultivate that into your morning routine. Have that be part of your magic morning routine every morning, even if it's just for 5 minutes. 5 minutes of just total relaxation, steeping in the bliss and the glory of your dream realized, as if you already have it. So that's the first and most important step. Without that, nothing else I'm about to share with you will make any difference. I promise you. The next step, the next hack, hack number two, is fill your cup first. What does that mean? Fill your cup first. Well, we're not talking about being a barista at Starbucks. We're not talking about pouring yourself a Java. What we're talking about is filling your own cup of self-care, your own cup of your inner resources, your own sense of well-being, your own sense of vitality, health, personal growth, spiritual alignment, spiritual growth. Your sense of well-being is absolutely mission critical. Many of you know this to be true and have intimate acquaintance with knowing this to be true as of late, because you've been swept off your feet, busier than you ever have before, because these crazy low rates are having the rising tide of the refi boom have you do record volume numbers. If you're fortunate enough to be in the game long enough to have a database to be able to ride that high tide of the refi boom. And for those of you who are 3 years or younger in this business, maybe you haven't been able to ride that tide and you've been feeling like you've been missing out. Well, this is one of the ways to get on track to ride the wave of momentum in your business. Fill your cup first. You hop on an airplane with a kid, what do they tell you in the safety instructions? Parents or people taking care of others, don your own mask first. Those who have dependents, don your own mask first before helping a dependent. What does that mean? It means you can't give that which you don't have. If you don't have health or vitality, how are you going to have the fuel to go up the mountain of success? You're going to be on the side of the road billowing smoke halfway up the mountain. Why? Because you're running on fumes, because you're not taking time to maintain your engine. You've got to maintain it. You've got to put the right premium plus fuel in your tank, and you've got to oil it, and you've got to have it tuned up so that you're able to continue to move upwards, expand upwards, and grow upwards towards that summit of success. So often what we see people do when they get really busy is they have this excuse, oh, I'm too busy. Once I get my to-do list done, then I'll start going to the gym. Once I get my to-do list done, then I'll take time for myself. Once I get my to-do list done, then fill in the blank. That is the wrong way to approach it, because you never get your to-do list done. Have you noticed? There's always more shit to do. There's always an avalanche of shit to do when you're an entrepreneur. Such is the plight of the ambitious. You might as well get used to it. Here's the most liberating thing I discovered along my journey being an entrepreneur for 2 decades now. You never get it all done. It's never all done. There's always more. There's always more. There's always more shit to do. So instead of chasing this delusional fleeting butterfly that's forever elusive of trying to get it all done before you take care of yourself, what if you were to flip it on its head? Because as Dr. Phil would say, how's waiting for someday working out for you? How's that working for you so far? Chances are not very well. Because if you're anything like me, if you delay those things that really matter to fuel your rocket and fill your cup, you end up feeling depleted, defeated, depressed, out of shape, drained, and then you beat yourself up saying, I should be doing more. I should be taking better care of myself. So now you're beating yourself up with shame and guilt, knowing you should be taking care of yourself and you're not. And that just compounds it, makes it worse. Can you relate to this? Chances are you can. So filling your cup first means having a prerogative and a priority to feel great every single day, to feel fantastic every single day. What if that was your primary goal every single day? Your foremost goal every single day is not to get a bunch of shit done, but to feel great and to feel at your best every single day. What if that was your priority? How would you reorder your day? How would you reorder your mornings? Chances are you would shift a lot of things that you're pouring time and energy into. You'd shift a lot of priorities, would you not? Chances are you take time to fill your cup first, taking care of your health, your fitness, taking care of your own spiritual and mental, emotional well-being, taking care to fill your cup first with the things that ignite you, excite you, fill you, inspire you, get you feeling great, get you feeling energized, get you feeling great in your body, great in your mind, great in your spirit. See, when you fill your own cup first, what it allows you to do is have more travel in your shocks. It's like if you're going back roading and your vehicle only has 2 inches of travel in your shocks, and you're going over ruts and you're going over potholes and you're going over all these ditches and ups and downs and whoopsie-doos, how enjoyable do you think that ride's gonna be if you have 2 inches of travel on those shocks? You're gonna be beat up and battered. You're gonna have bolts and nuts and parts of your vehicle falling off the freaking vehicle in no time. It's gonna be a hard-ass road and a hard-ass ride. Why? Because you don't have the buffer, the energetic buffer of the travel that you need to be able to absorb those shocks. So when the shit hits the fan, when things go awry, when you have a deal that goes sideways, you're freaking out because you're running on fumes. And so you're being hit with these challenges with maximum impact. And you wonder why you are feeling burnt out. You're wondering why you're feeling so stressed out. You're wondering why you're feeling so defeated and depleted. Well, wonder no longer. You got 2 inches of freaking travel, my friend. We've got to give you more buffer. So by filling your cup first, what it's doing is it's expanding your travel. So instead of 2 inches of travel, now you have 22 inches of travel. Now, the same challenges ain't no thing like a chicken wing. It's like, man, I got this. I feel powerful. I feel poised. I feel peaceful. I feel unstoppable. Have you ever had that feeling of vitality, of resourcefulness, where you just feel good in your body, good in your spirit? You feel resourceful and you have your tank full of resourcefulness. It's like anything could come your way and you'll chew through it. You'll go over it. You'll go around it. You'll find a way. Because you feel great in your spirit. You feel great energetically. When you feel good, you tend to do good. Have you noticed that to be true? So that's the principle called fill your cup first. Give yourself the gift. Self-care is the most generous thing you can ever do for those who you care about and you care for. Lack of self-care is the most selfish thing you can do because now you're running on fumes. Now you're, you know, showing your fangs more than you'd like, right? Now you're starting to get a little snarly, a little snappy. Now you're a little grumpy. Now you're a little, you know, you're short or you're on edge. And that doesn't serve anybody. So fill your own cup first. It's a huge productivity hack that most people overlook because they're always trying to get their to-do list done first. They're majoring in the minors. It's time to major in the majors. The third productivity hack is maximize your mornings. Maximize your mornings. I can't tell you how many times I've struggled with this and I've seen my clients do likewise. So I thought it's so important to talk about because it's often one of the things we struggle with the most, but it's the little hinge that can swing open such a big door to such a big breakthrough in your productivity. Maximizing your mornings. What's our inclination in the morning? Our inclination in the morning for most people is to hop on our phones, start scrolling on social media, start scrolling on the news apps, start taking in our email, and all of a sudden we get into this energy of reaction, right? We're reacting to inbound stimuli, whether it be emails coming in, whether it be messages coming in or notifications coming in. And so we start our days in reactionary mode. And then we wonder why at the end of the day, even after all this activity, we feel like we didn't really get much done in terms of productivity. Well, wonder no longer. If you start your day in reactive mode, that sets the tone for your whole day, does it not? Now you're putting out fires and dealing with low level issues and getting sucked in the vortex of all that minutia and all that operations minutia. And once you get into that energetic frequency, it's hard to get out. It's hard to be proactive. It's hard to work on your business, not just in your business, when you get sucked into the vortex of this frequency of being in reactionary mode. Have you noticed this? Chances are I'm not the only one. Chances are you can relate to this intimately, right? So maximizing your morning is based on the principle of starting your mornings, filling your cup first. Maybe that's exercise. Maybe that's what I call learn and burn. So while your hands are busy, your mind is free. Two birds, one stone. So listen to some inspiration, motivation, education. Give thanks for your dream in advance as if you already have it. Feel that feeling, knowing it's already yours. Get yourself attuned to the frequency of victory. Maybe it's time in the scriptures. If you have a spiritual journey or a spiritual conviction, it's time in your scriptures, time on your knees in prayer, time to get centered and anchored to source. The key is to start your mornings creating a magic morning routine that gets you feeling fantastic, fueling your rocket, filling your cup. And then before you get into pipeline management or putting out fires or checking your email or reading the news or any of that other stuff that sucks into the vortex, you channel that frequency of victory that you've cultivated, that sense of certainty, that sense of vitality, that sense of being on purpose with purpose and being in a powerful emotional state. You channel that energy towards the most potently profitable activity you can ever do, which would be proactive prospecting to fill your pipeline with new deals, as opposed to pipeline management email that has you be in reactionary mode. Yes, is it easy to slip into reactionary mode? Yes. Is it easy to slip into putting out fires? Yes. Is it easy to be seduced into checking emails and chewing up an hour doing that or scrolling on social media? Yes. But the way of the champion is to do the things that are hard, to do the things most people aren't willing to do today so you can get the results most people aren't going to get tomorrow. So it's all about swimming upstream. It's the counterintuitive way. It's the road less traveled. So maximizing your mornings means enacting discipline on yourself to not do the things you're normally inclined to do and leaving that for later, knowing that this better way, even though it's the harder way, even though it's the most challenging way, even though it's out of your comfort zone, doing it, even though it's uncomfortable, is going to give you the most comfortable life. It's the counterintuitive paradox of life that when you do the things that are uncomfortable, life is going to be mighty comfortable. If you only do the things that come comfortable to you and you just drift with the current of the average, life is going to be mighty uncomfortable. It's the paradox of life. So it's swimming upstream just like a salmon does. And by doing that, you're cultivating what I call a champion level habit, a champion level routine. Everyone wants to get champion level results, but most people aren't willing to do the hard work of cultivating champion level routines. And that's the rub, because it's uncomfortable, because it ain't easy, because it's swimming upstream against the current. That ain't easy. But that's why the glory of success is so glorious, because few are willing to enact the simple disciplines of success for long enough to get to the top of the mountain. And it's not about just getting to the top of the mountain. It's about knowing that life, the juice of life, is to be growing, to be constantly growing. There's always that next summit. It's not about getting to the top of the mountain and then sitting on your laurels. It's about knowing that the spout from which all the good stuff pours out is growing, expanding, becoming the best version of yourself. And that's what the maximizing the morning routine is all about. That's what the magic morning routine is all about. It's about pouring into yourself. Imagine that you are your most important client. And that is a true statement. You are your most important client. What if you block scheduled your mornings all the way till 10 a.m. just for you to fill your cup, to fuel your rocket, to build yourself up mentally, emotionally, spiritually. And now you're ready to kick ass, take names, and chew bubblegum for the rest of your day. Even if your day goes to hell in a handbasket with putting out fires for the rest of the day after 10 or 11, how much more magical and powerful and productive would your day be if you fuel your rocket and fill your cup in the morning by maximizing your morning with a magic morning routine? You gotta be knowing that's gonna be a massive shift energetically for you, a massive shift in how you show up as a leader, a massive shift in how you lead yourself and others. True or not true? You gotta be knowing that is absolutely a game changer when you enact it. But it's not enough to just know it, you gotta put it to practice. Just like it's not enough to just know that eating healthy and exercise is gonna make you fit and feel better in your body. Everyone knows that. Very few people do it. Why? Because there's a disconnect between knowledge, information, and transformation. Information is knowing it in your head. Transformation is knowing it in your heart and living by it. My goal for you is that you shift from information to transformation, from your head to your heart. That's the shift that changes everything. So maximize your mornings. That's hack three. Hack four is delegate operations. Superstars only. Delegate operations. That means instead of being the chief cook and bottle washer, wearing all the hats, doing everything yourself and being burnt out and frazzled and fried because you're doing everything. You're doing sales, you're doing paperwork, you're chasing docs, you're ordering appraisals, you're showing up to the closing table, you're doing everything from A to Z. There's only so many of those deals you can do. Chances are you're going to tap out around 8 to 10 deals a month doing that. And you're going to work really freaking hard for your money. If you want to claim true freedom in your business, if you don't want to just have a practice that enslaves you, trading time for money on the time for money treadmill, but you want to have a true business that sets you free, that allows you to liberate yourself from the grind of trading time for money, then you need to start to delegate as soon as possible. But Doran, I don't have the money. Well, that's precisely why you want to delegate, so that you can have more time and bandwidth to focus on proactive lead generation, to focus on building your business and making it rain, proactive prospecting. The more time you can be liberated out of operations, you can focus more on dancing in your strengths in proactive lead generation. That's what's going to push the needle at the highest level to have you continue to increase your income while also increasing your freedom. So there's two principles here. One is, you want to spend more and more time on proactive lead generation, working on your business, not just in your business, to be the rainmaker. So you're the one bringing in the deals. You're the one who's making the phone ring. You're the one who's originating new borrowers who are hot for what you got. That is your primary and most potently profitable role, is being director of business development. That needs to be your primary focus, and you want to be spending more and more time on that. Because that's how you're going to put more zeros and commas in your bank account. That's how you're going to claim more freedom. If you channel a certain percentage of that additional revenue towards hiring top talent team members to handle all the minutiae, to handle taking applications, to handle going from application to closing, to handle chasing docs, to handle processing, to handle the underwriting process. So you want to be able to delegate more and more of that operations. So you're just doing the stuff you do best. You want to just do what you do best, get the best to do all the rest. That means superstars only. You will not settle for anything less than a freaking rock star, a superstar in each respective role. So everyone now is a specialist. It's a dream team. You're the best at what you do at making it rain. They're the best at what they do on handling all the minutiae. And mark my words, let's not get things twisted. Their job is just not to be on a payroll. Their job is not just to do some admin. Their job is and always will be to liberate you, to set you free to dance in your strengths, to operate in your zone of genius. And I recommend you let them know that, that their job is to liberate you. And the more better equipped they are, the better trained they are, the more policy, procedure, protocol, and systems they have to undergird what they do, the more they're supported to liberate you. So that's your job as a leader, is to support them to liberate you. So that's the fourth hack. Delegate operations, superstars only. The fifth hack, last but certainly not least, is an hour of power. I can't tell you how many mortgage professionals I meet and talk to who don't even invest in an hour a day on proactive lead generation. If they do, they're doing it the hard way, cold calling realtors every Monday, or you know, doing some posts on social media that no one looks at, or the wrong people are looking at. They don't have the right eyeballs looking at it. And so they're just, you know, doing a bunch of splashing in the ocean, but they're not getting anywhere. They're throwing a bunch of yogurt at the fan, but not a whole lot is sticking. So they're putting in a bunch of time, a bunch of activity, but they're not getting much in the way of productivity. The hour of power is all about channeling an hour of focused, non-negotiable, potently productive time towards proactive lead generation. That means if you have a database, reaching out to past clients, seeing whether or not if they need your help, seeing if it's their birthday, celebrate their birthday. If it's their mortgage anniversary date, to see if there's anything that's changed since last mortgage anniversary date, and to help them get more clarity and have more navigation in getting to the best outcome when it comes to their finances. You are their advisor for life. You're the mortgage advisor for life. That means you should be checking in with them at least once a year. If you're not doing that, you're leaving a shit ton of money on the table, because those magic moments when you're connecting with them over the phone, for example, once a year, that's where you reconnect. That's where you build rapport. That's where you strengthen the relationship. That's where you get referrals for your dream team. That's where you get referrals for yourself. So that connection is mission critical. If you have a database, you want to be doing that, and you want to have a systematic approach to do that. The best people to be asking for referrals are people who give you a five-star review. Are you asking your rave reviewers, your brand ambassadors, for referrals? If you're not, you need a system for that. You need a campaign for that. That's a big reason why people hire us, is to get those locked and loaded, tried and true, proven, key in the ignition, and drive away time-tested campaigns. That's what we do, so that you don't have to reinvent the wheel trying to create all this stuff from scratch. But connecting with clients, at least three clients a day, all that takes is half an hour. Three client connections a day, it's all it takes is half an hour. Could you do that if you were sufficiently inspired? Absolutely, you could. The only thing that stops you is your tendency and proclivity towards having the current, the average, you know, the current of average pull you into putting out fires, dealing with loan level issues, and being in reactionary mode, because that's more comfortable. But if you want to be mighty comfortable, you got to do the things that are uncomfortable. And if you want to do the things that are uncomfortable, life will be mighty comfortable. If you only do the things that are comfortable, life is going to be mighty uncomfortable. It's the paradox of life again. So if you want to get champion level results, you got to get those champion level routines. And so the hour of power, if you have a database, should have some portion of it allocated towards reaching out to past clients. It's one of the best sources of repeat and referral business, is making those connections, but doing it scientifically and intelligently. So it's called inspired intelligent action. So instead of just chasing your tail, splashing around in the water, hoping you're going to get somewhere, you actually have form and technique and intelligence enacted in how you're swimming. So you're going in the right direction with efficiency, not just activity, but productivity. And then the second portion of what you want to be doing during your hour of power, which should be non-negotiable time right after you fill your cup, right after your magic morning routine, when you're feeling at your absolute freaking best, when you feel on fire, when you feel unstoppable, when you feel energized, that's when you want to be spending time in your hour of power. Not at the end of the day when you've been banging your head against the wall, putting out fires all day, and you're drained, you're dragging your butt, you're completely defeated and depleted, and you're feeling terrible. That's not the time to be reaching out and doing proactive lead generation, right? You know that to be true, because chances are you've tried it. You don't feel right. You don't feel powerful. You're transmitting a frequency of lack, limitation, scarcity. How well do you think that's going to go? You plant those kind of seeds of lack, limitation, scarcity, and feeling just deadbeat tired, how productive, how fruitful do you think those seeds will be? Not very fruitful, not very productive, right? So you want to be planting the best seeds. That means plant the best seeds when you're feeling at your best, right after your magic morning routine. And then the second portion of your hour of power should be reaching out to top producing agents who the goal would be to have them make you their exclusive and put you on their speed dial and send you all their business all the time, working on your terms, not theirs. How do you do that? You need a kick-ass unique value proposition. You need to have the posture and positioning such that they need you more than easy for me to say, they need you more than you need them. And you need to be able to have such a kick-ass stack of awesome that you bring to the table exclusively for your VIP partners who qualify that they're not interviewing you, you're interviewing them. So we're flipping the script entirely. So that's, again, another big reason why people hire us in the mortgage space is to have that locked and loaded turnkey system where they don't have to reinvent the wheel on that. It's just stick the key in the ignition and drive away so that you have a kick-ass value proposition, so that you have the words that work, so that you have a proven campaign that gets these top producing agents receptive and eager to meet with you without making a single cold call. No more cold calling the same 40 freaking realtors every Monday. That's doing it the hard way. No more trying to chase and beg and grovel for business. That's doing it the hard way. Instead of chase, attract. Instead of push, pull, draw them in. The more you have a kick-ass value proposition, the more you can have them not only attracted to you, but have them stick to you like super glue, send you all their business exclusively, and work on your terms. Now you're in the power position. Now you're in the driver's seat. Now you're in control. And if you haven't got that dynamic in your business, you're doing it the hard way. But truth be told, top producing agents are and always will be the most potently profitable source of referrals, bar none. Do you have a system to attract them? Do you have a method by which to attract them to you and have them make you their exclusive? If you don't, you're leaving a lot of money on the table. You're definitely doing it the hard way. And again, that's a big reason why people hire us, is to fill that gap in their marketing bucket. Because if you think about it, if you want to close an extra, say, 10 deals a month, if that's your gap between where you are and where you want to be, 10 deals a month, all that is, it's not chasing a bunch of crap leads on Facebook. It's not going to a bunch of open houses or networking events. Even if, you know, right now with COVID, they're not even doing open houses and many of these networking events are not even happening anymore. But if they were, it's not that, okay? It's not that. It's not doing a bunch of advertising on Google AdWords, although that stuff can work to some degree. Chances are it's not going to give you 10 deals a month. The shortest path to the cash is and always will be getting top producing agents, not the bottom feeding, whining, sniveling, complaining, jelly donut eating low producers. We're talking about the top dogs doing 20 plus transactions a month. All you need is 10 of those sending you one loan a month to bridge the gap from where you are to where you want to be. Just 10. All we're talking about is 10. You know what that is? 20 meetings, 20 well-executed meetings. The way we teach and preach and the way we empower our clients to operate, 20 meetings converts to 10 VIP partners, converts to 10 deals a month. It's as simple as that. It ain't rocket science, friends. It's very simple once you know how to do it. So that being said, if you're listening to this, you're like, Dorn, I'm loving what you're putting down. I get it. I like the way you think. I'm all about working smarter, not harder. I'm all about elegant simplicity. I like the idea of being able to fuel my rocket first, fill my cup first. I love the idea of getting myself feeling at my best every day. And instead of majoring in the minors, major in the majors, put in my big rocks first, be able to have myself dialed in so I'm bringing my best, showing up and shining every day and becoming the best version of myself. I love the idea of liberating myself from the minutiae of operations so I can focus on making it rain, dancing in my strengths, doing what I do best, getting the best to do all the rest. I love that. I love the idea of being able to have an hour of power every day to be able to proactively fill my pipeline with more closings and to be able to do that in a way that's potently productive and that's potently profitable. The question, Dorn, is how do I do that? Because I get it in theory. I get it in concept, but there's a big difference between information and transformation, like we talked about before. How do I actually do this without wasting my time trying to reinvent the wheel? If that's you and you're on 100% commission and you have an 80 basis points comp plan or better, rate increases are coming down the pipe. And you don't want to be caught with your pants down, unequipped and ill-equipped when rates go up and refis drop, to have to catch up on all that revenue that was lost with the refi boom that you've been enjoying, hopefully. Hopefully you've been enjoying your best year yet this year with this refi boom. You don't want to be in regression. You don't want to be in stagnation. You don't want to be scrambling to recoup that revenue. You want to be proactive in building your purchase pipeline. You don't want to have to reinvent the wheel, and you don't want to have to bang your head against the wall, spinning your wheels in the same spot, doing it the hard way. You just want to get straight to what works. You just want a recipe, a formula, a blueprint that works when you work it. If that's you and you're defiantly committed to adding at least $100,000 or more to your annual income, working smarter, not harder, and you want to claim more freedom for your life, more freedom for your family, you want to have more fun, more flow, more fulfillment, and you just want to be able to show up and shine and just enjoy your career without grinding. Screw grinding. Let's get into flow, not the grind, but the flow. If that's you, I invite you to take advantage of a complimentary breakthrough call where we get on the phone one-on-one with either myself or one of my consultants. We lift up the hood on your business. We have a real talk, honest conversation about where you're at now, where you want to be. And we identify the gap between where you are, where you want to be. And if it looks like we can help you to bridge that gap and to help you create your breakthrough, by all means, we'll show you what that looks like and how to accomplish that. If not, we will be the first to advise you to pass on our services. Perhaps we'll recommend something else or someone else. Either way, though, you'll leave that breakthrough call with more clarity than you ever have before on what it really takes to create a breakthrough in your business. And you'll have massive value in terms of key distinctions you didn't know before getting on the call. And chances are we'll even have some fun. So if that sounds meaningful and worthwhile to you, I invite you to take advantage of a complimentary breakthrough call by booking it at mortgagemarketingcoach.com/apply. Again, that's mortgagemarketingcoach.com/apply. Just book a time in the calendar. Let's have a chat. Let's connect and let's see what we can do to help you create a breakthrough, not just in 2021, but also beyond, to be able to have a thriving career, not just surviving, but thriving, not just grinding, but getting into flow, getting into fun, getting into fulfillment, getting into your best version of yourself with fitness and fun and flow, and being in a state where you feel fantastic about who you're becoming, the impact you're making, and the leader that you're becoming on the journey. Because at the end of the day, when you feel like you're at your best and you're growing and you're bringing the best version of yourself, that's the juice of life right there. So if you'd like to pour gasoline on the fire on that, book a call, mortgagemarketingcoach.com/apply. Thank you for the gift and the privilege of serving you. You guys are awesome. I'm so delighted and excited every time I see people coming into our fold on Planet Prosper and having them show up coachable, committed, resourceful, decisive, treat our system like their freaking life depends on it. And then they ignite, they double, they triple, they quadruple their income. They start to step into their power like never before. They start to step into the truest version of themselves. That's unstoppable, that eats challenges for freaking breakfast and turns them into opportunities. I love that. And that's why I do what I do. That's my passion. That's what ignites me and excites me every single day. That's what gets me bouncing out of bed in the morning. And so I'm just blessed and grateful to be on this journey with you guys. And I'm excited to be able to connect with you. If you book a call, I'm looking forward to connecting with you. And just remember, freedom, it may be free, but it ain't cheap. Freedom comes at a cost. We're honoring the fallen who sacrificed, in many cases, their lives, certainly sacrificed putting their lives on the line for our freedom. It may be free, but it ain't cheap. We honor all those people today on Freedom Day, Veterans Day, Remembrance Day. And so in honor of that, I invite you guys to step up and claim your freedom. Life is too short to just get by and make do. Let's not make do. Screw frickin' that. Let's make history, shall we? All right, friends, be blessed. Dornell Dana coming at you from the Art of Mortgage Marketing podcast. We just talked about the 5 productivity hacks for maximizing your freedom so you can earn more while working less. We'll talk to you again soon. Peace.